Welcome to round one. So I joined two mans because obviously the eight mans just don't fill up at all these days. I really looking forward to play leagues, but it was somehow closed. So I guess it's going to be available after the downtime. Okay, so with this hand, we've got Gorva's Vengeance, which is the after Grizzlebrand, the second best card in the deck. But it's pretty slow. Like, we've got Night's Whispers, we're on the draw here, opponent Mulliganed. We've got two Through the Breaches, which is obviously the second one is useless. I'm gonna mulligan this because we're really looking for two different cards here. We're looking for a Grizzlebrand and a way to discard it with this hand, which is kind of loose, and it's kind of like a sick card hand anyway because of this. So I'm gonna mulligan this. And scrying with this deck is very important as well. All right, so this hand has got Nourishing Shoal and World's Power Worm and Grizzlebrand, so all cards we want, but obviously it's got no lands, so we're gonna mulligan. And still no lands, although we have Faithless Looting, but Faithless Looting is pretty bad when you only have 5 cards and no Grizzlebrands. I'm thinking it might be a keep. Yeah, I think it's gotta be a keep. I'm likely to do nothing, but I could get there. I definitely don't want that. And also on the draw with a scry. Let's get there. And we don't, and we drew one of the worst cards. Okay. So, I don't know, I guess I could have mulliganed just because I can still just like have Faithless Looting, Gorva's Vengeance, and Grizzlebrand, a land on 4. That's very unlikely though. But nah, I think it's still fine keep. Like, we also had Simeon's Prayer Guy, which is a card we could draw. So exile it, play Faithless Looting. We drew a land. We'll discard 2 World Spine Worms. I guess I could have scooped and like, in hopes of not telling him what we're playing, but we're playing against John, which is a pretty good matchup if they don't have Scavenging Ooze. So, and we can still win. It's a long shot, but we can still win. And he's got Scavenging Ooze. Yeah, that's gonna be close to impossible to win this game. We need to find Through the Breach, basically. And a bunch of lands. Tormenting Voice, discard this. It's pretty bad. Opponent revealed Blood Crypt. Down to 12, and a Goyf. I'm not even sure I want to cast this Faithless Looting because I don't really have cards I want to discard. So basically, with this hand, my plan is to draw Through the Breach and then play Nourishing Shoal, exile Nourishing Shoal, splice Through the Breach on it. So I need a land, an extra land, and a Through the Breach, which is impossible because I don't have 2 turns. So, how can I win with this hand? If I Through the Breach, if I Faithless Looting, I mean, maybe I can actually find Lightning Axe, kill the Scavenging it was in, and somehow draw Gorga. Yeah, whatever. I guess, yeah, I can still gain like 13 life, 12, 11 life. So the number one planet through to reach is just not going to work with this game. Okay, Simmons Spirit Guide doesn't get me anywhere. So discard Shoal. And Spirit Guide. Place Blood Crypt. And not casting Fearless Looting yet. Plus one in his ooze because he exiled my Simon Spirit guy. Haunt Master. Plays a Blood Crypt. Attacks for 6 and 8. I'm down to 4. And well, okay, so we draw Grizzlebrand. I'm gonna flashback Faithless Looting, I believe. So I basically wanna find Lightning Axe. And Gora's Vengeance, obviously, but that's something we're gonna have to top deck next turn. Okay, so these won't do it since I'm gonna have to play Nourishing Shoal, so I would have to draw. Yeah, there's basically nothing I can draw so that I can cast it next turn. So I could if I didn't have to play Nourishing Shoal, but I have to, so I'm gonna discard them. And I think I'm somewhat dead because I don't think I can get there on my next turn. I play Nourishing Shoal, it's like an extra turn. Yeah. I have to exile this, and he takes my Faithless Looting, and like I guess if I top deck Lightning Axe, I can Lightning Axe the ooze, but that actually doesn't work because it's the additional cost to discard the Grizzlebrand, which means you could scavenge use it and I'd be dead. So yeah, I messed up kind of. I mean, I messed up, but I don't think there was any other line. All right, he's attacking, and we have no out. Yeah. I mean, he's tapped out. No, I don't think there's anything I can draw. Nope. Concede. All right, let's go game two. All right, so keeping through the breaches is needed because he has Scavenging Oozes. Lightning Axe is good for Scavenging Oozes, obviously. Blood Moon is something we definitely want as a way to. It's definitely insane when you play it on the play. So I'm gonna board out one Metamorphos. It's one of the cards that's not needed in the deck. Same for Borborygmos. Actually, I've not understood yet why there's two Borborygmos. I guess it's an extra card for Nourishing Shoal, but it feels a little bit unnecessary. So anyways, here I am boarding one out. I feel like I don't want to discard I don't want to board out Night's Whispers because he's gonna try to. He's gonna try to get me with discard spells. So I'm not gonna bore those out. Tormenting Voice. Tormenting Voice is probably a card I can board out. Yeah, that seems like a little bit unnecessary. So I'm gonna go with these. I might sometime get punished because I don't have the second board boring most, but I'm not sure. I guess it could be like a problem if he discards it and then removes it with Ooze. But then again, he should expect that I have two, so he wouldn't really do that. Or, I mean, I also can win, like, without it. I can get Grizzlebrand and then draw a bunch of cards and then through the breach a World Spine Worm. And that's still lethal. So I'm going to go with this. We'll be on the play. Okay, so this hand's got a lot of rituals. So it's basically just missing a guy, because we already have access to 4 mana for Through the Breach. So we're really just missing one threat to put into play with Through the Breach. I'm going to keep this. If I find Blood Moon with the temple, it's pretty good as well. All right, our opponent kept 7. And we scry Grizzlebrand. That's great. So we just have to find a mana. Sure. I might consider even boarding out one Gore's Vengeance for next game if he has Nihilus Problem and Scavenging Ooze. So I'm going to cast Faithless Looting, hopefully finding land. I have not found a land. I'm going to discard Grizzlebrand and Night's Whispers. Yeah, I think so. Yeah, I think that's it. I just want this Faithless Looting to find me one land, so. Alright, just cracking it right away. He's probably looking for a land or something like that. Or maybe just a discard spell. Doesn't have a discard spell. And that's not a land. It could be. So if I decide to Spirit Guide here, and I basically gamble of drawing a land with Metamorphose, which is somewhat greedy. I wonder if I actually want to do that. So if I Spirit Guide, then play Metamorphose, I don't find my land, then I lost one Spirit Guide. But then I can play Faithless Looting, find a land, and I can still top deck a land next turn. But I feel like I'm not really in a rush anyway. Yeah, I'm just going to play Faithless Looting. Okay, we found a land and Gore's Vengeance. Okay, so I can win with Gore's Vengeance here, because I can discard Grizzlebrand and let's say Through the Breach. Play my land, Simeon Spirit Guide, Metamorphose, and I play Gordo's thing. So cast it. Hopefully he doesn't have like an instant speed that discards something. Two black, doesn't matter. Gore's Vengeance. So, I mean, I guess I somewhat misplayed. I could have played this spiritual first. No, I don't think it matters. Bring back Grizzlebrand. Gonna draw a bunch. Does he have something? No, he doesn't. Just wants to f6. Okay, so no nourishing shoal. Which means I think I have to attack. I can spirit guide, desperate ritual, and that's only 4. Yeah, I have to attack. Hopefully I find a nourishing shoal. We haven't found one. Okay, that's kind of insane. This has not happened to me before. So I guess now I have the Faithless Looting. We also don't have the Barbaring Moose. And we need it, kind of. No, we don't really need it, because we can still through the breach World Spine Worm. We also haven't found World Spine Worm. We haven't found through the breach. So, I'm gonna need the Spirit Guide, Faithless Looting. Now let's see if I'm gonna have enough mana for the rest. So if I use one Spirit Guide, I'm gonna be left with 2 Spirit Guides in my deck. Do I have it? Okay, so I have it in my hand already. So I have 2 Spirit Guides and 2 Desperate Rituals. And how many Desperate Rituals do I have in my hand? I have both of them. I can splice one on one Nourishing Shoal. So I can still get up to 5 mana. Alright, so let's do this. Exile 1. Play Faithless Looting. Or maybe I want Exile 2. Play a few Metamorphoses. Yeah, I'm going to do that actually. Because that way I can actually cycle a little bit more. I'm seeing one. I have one Metamorphose. I'm seeing one more card. Yeah. So Metamorphose. Gonna add red and black, I guess. It's not really, it doesn't really matter. We drew a Grizzlebrand, so that's not what we want. Let's play a Faithless Looting. We still haven't drawn Nourishing Shoal. That's insane. I might not be able to win. Okay, so I think the plan here will be, so let's card Grizzlebrand for sure. And let's say a World Spine Worm that we're gonna shuffle back. So okay, so I can use another Spirit Guide and play Desperate Ritual. So up to 3 mana. I play a Faithless Looting down to 2. And no, I can't, because I can't cast Through the Breach, and I can't cast Gora's Vengeance, because both of my mana morphos is on the graveyard. So alright, so I think I'm going to have to just cast Blood Moon, get up to 5 mana, and through to breach a Grizzlebrand, I believe. So here we are. Play it. And play Blood Moon. And go to discard. It's the first time it happens to me. But I fizzle with Grizzlebrand. Okay, so I'm gonna discard I guess some of those. 1, 2. Who would have dealt So I don't need this. I don't need mountains. Mustang Mire. So I need a total of 5 lands. So I guess this. This. I want to find. So I don't need Gorio's Vengeance. Well, I guess. No, I guess I could just Gorio's Vengeance a bunch. My Grizzlebrands. And then hit him. Yes, I'm going to keep at least one. I don't need a second Blood Moon. And I guess I don't need this Desperate Ritual because... No, it's the same thing as a land, so whatever. So discard one. And maybe a one of Spine and Worm. Faithless Looting. Yeah, discard Faithless Looting. He has a forest, so it's semi-annoying. Okay, so let's go to his Vengeance. Attack for 7. So there's still one left in my deck, so if I hit him, you could die. Did I board out my Nourishing Shoals, or... I still have 0. Anyways. So... Yeah, I'm gonna go to discard step. Discard the Grizzlebrand, and... be done with it. Discard this. This, maybe Lightning Axe, yeah, Night's Whispers, and that's it. Alright, and we win. So, let's just say it's basically impossible to lose with Grizzlebrand. So, even if I, like, got super unlucky, I could still win after. So, we saw an Nihil Spell Bomb, so could think of boarding out a Gorio's Vengeance. I think on the play was fine to keep 4, because you can have the turn 2 kill quite easily with just Faithless Looting, Gorio's Vengeance, and Grizzlebrand. So, but on the draw, it's more likely that he has Scavenging Ooze. I guess it's not going to be active yet. But again, I don't like Tormenting Voice because I'm basically just discarding a land. I'm discarding a creature. I want to discard a creature with it, and then I'm exposing myself to his graveyard hate. So I'm just gonna keep it the same. Alright, so here we've got the nuts. We've got the Faithless Looting, Grizzlebrand, Gorio's Vengeance, and Madness to play it. So, I cannot mulligan this. It could be a little bit loose against the discard spell, but we just have, like, we cannot mulligan this. It's just too good. If he doesn't have it, it's GG, so. He doesn't have a discard spell, so if we draw. So if we even draw a second spirit guy, we can kill in turn 1, which I've never done before. Okay, it might not happen this turn. I think I'm gonna start with Temple because I wanna surprise him by killing him on turn 2, so I'm just going to Spirit Guy, Faithless Looting, dump Grizzlebrand, and not give him the information that I could kill him next turn by playing Faithless Looting turn 1. I could start with Faithless Looting turn 1 by removing Spirit Guide, and then hope to draw another Spirit Guide. It seems a little bit risky. I don't see what he could have on turn 2, basically. If he didn't have a discard spell there, maybe he has Ooze, and then Ooze is not going to be enough anyway, so. All right, well, we had the spirit guide on top. Do we want to keep it? I don't think so. Yeah, I don't think so. All right, got Overgrown Tomb. Hopefully he plays like just a creature that turn. And we get him next turn. Yep, so we got him. Unless we get uber unlucky. So, fetch, get swamp. Fateless Looting. One and two. Exile this, cast, bring it back, and we draw a bunch of cards. Hopefully we find some Nourishing Shoals, we still haven't. That's insane. Can I through the breach yet? No, I can't. I'm just gonna attack. Okay, we found one. We found one. We found a Desperate Ritual. So I'm going to splice it, I believe. Yeah, so I'm going to remove this. This. Two mana. Going to cast this and splice additional spells. So I don't have Metamorphose yet, do I? I don't. So, yeah, I'm moving this. I'm splicing this on it. It resolves. Yeah. Just making sure I don't mess up here. So, again, a bunch of life. I can play Desperate Ritual. Could draw six. So I basically need one extra mana. Find Nourishing Shoal. Let's draw seven more. Okay, so we can cast this. Cast this. Through the Breach. Put Boring Moss in play. And discard all our lands. One, two, three, and he's dead. All right, so let's see you for match number two.